next shot. I hear Adler thinks you're good enough to join our crew. You betting your life on that? Because the only way out of our organization is with a warhead up your grab drive. So, before I put you to work, let's get everything out in the open. I don't know if Adler mentioned it, and for his sake, I hope he hasn't. But you aren't about to sign up with any average pirate crew. You're signing up with the Crimson Fleet. That's if you get through this little task I have planned for you. There's a medical supply ship called the Rigana, jumping into Enceladus's orbit. On board that ship, you'll find a traitor named Austin Rake. I want him dead. This job isn't about the loot, but I suppose every dog needs its scraps. Keep whatever worthless junk is on that ship. Just remember, the only thing that matters is that Rake dies. It's done when Rake stops breathing. Head back here when you're finished. And don't keep me waiting for long. Rake used to run with the fleet. Hell, I'm the one who... Back then he had a different name and a different identity. He was a damn good earner, too. Brought in a ton of creds. Everything was fine until he wanted out. So he ran. And nobody... I mean, nobody... runs away from the fleet. I've been tracking Rake for months. He changes his location, but you know what?
Not sure what to make of you being here. If you wanted to kill us, you could have done that from your ship. If you wanted our cargo, we could have jettisoned it. I guess I should just stop talking and let you say your piece. That is true. Which means you don't want somebody to know what you are really up to. Now, do you mind telling us what this is all about? You really do not know which one of us is Rake, do you? And you do not seem to care either, which makes me think you really want to save him. Okay, I have idea. We can strike his name from Manifest, make it so he was never on board. Then, when we dock, we will leave him on this ship and deliver him to another port. That is fair. We do not want any part of the fleet. Is that all right with you, Austin?
Do I have a choice?
It does not appear you do. Well then, it is agreed. You go back to your ship and we will make sure Rake was never on ours. And in case any of your handlers get suspicious, here. We had an extra crate of supplies loaded, in case one got damaged. This should be proof you were not here to bargain.
So you're the fleet's new dog, huh?
Thank you
for letting us go.
Job done. Anyway, You wanted into the Crimson Fleet? Well, you're in. Yep, it's that simple. Hope this business with Rakes taught you something. Because I'm about to stick my neck out and vouch for you. If you screw up, and I wind up looking like an asshole, I'm gonna send someone after you. We clear? Yeah? Last person who said that was Rake. So you've already dug yourself a hole about 6 feet deep. And now that you know the deal, it's time to see what you signed up for. I'm gonna upload the coordinates for our headquarters in the Crick system. Spacers call it the key, the fleet calls it home. Head out there as soon as you can. Don't keep me waiting long.
Commander Ikande wants to see you. Follow me.
I had a friend in Morgana.
I hope I'll be able to see him next time we're on shore leave.
Sysdef Marines are the best.
We got the message from the Regana about Austin Rake. We had him dropped off at a separate port, off the books. Suffice to say, he's got a lot to answer for. That's a smart line to follow. Part of this role you're playing means having to make hard choices. Just remember not to lose yourself in the part. Oh, one more thing before we move on. For transparency's sake, you should know we were the ones that hired Ecliptic to attack Neva's ship. There was concern after what happened with the Regana that you might have trouble earning Neva's trust. Coming to her rescue ensured that would not be a problem. Ah, so I take it you have good news. Were you able to join the fleet? Then it worked. You're in. Sounds like everything is going as expected. Now it's time for the next phase of the mission.
Our intel on Searsha was correct. After we received reports on your interaction with Adler Kemp, we picked up on your rendezvous with Neva Mora.
Alphas indicate she's second in command, so getting on her good side will ensure you get into the Crimson Fleet. That's where you're wrong. You can believe in honor among thieves, but I'd venture they suspect everyone until proven otherwise. You just need to make sure you allay any suspicions they have, staying within the proper moral boundaries, of course. Do what you have to, but not what you can't do.
The Crimson Fleet has yet to leave us enough hard evidence to build a solid case against them. Be careful not to underestimate their intelligence.
So, what's next for you on Neva's agenda? Where you'll meet Delgado, no doubt.
Delgado is the leader of the Crimson Fleet. I have a profile here with some information on his background. You'll want to know the individual cadences of every member of the fleet, but Delgado's, most of all.
In any case, now that you're with the fleet, you'll be operating independently. We will shadow you eventually, but we'll need to maintain our distance for now, especially while you're on the quay. This will also give us time to bolster our defenses, should we need to engage with the fleet in the future.
Sir, on that note, shall we begin implementing the upgrade to our shields?
Immediately, Lieutenant. Notify the engineers and relay the information to the crew. I hope your entry into the fleet has overcome any doubts you may have had regarding your mission. It certainly increased my estimates on success. Keep up the good work. We'll expect further reports. Dismissed.
Before it turns into a damn air freshener.
The hell took you so long? Forget how to grab jump or something?
Maybe for you. I'd rather shove a shotgun up my nose than remember the face of every low-life rook who passes through this station. But, all that aside, you made it. So now, you get to hear a nifty history lesson. Pencils ready? Good. This floating scrap heap you're standing on is called the Key. Used to be an old UC military star station, and now it's the fleet's base of operations. Might look a little beat up on the outside, but we keep it together. Hell yeah, it is. Just watch your back when you do. Cred sticks tend to disappear around here, if you catch my meaning. Anyway, I'll tell you all about the key, but it's better if I show you too. Follow me.
All right, history time. So, the key is in orbit around Suvorov. That's the very same ice ball where the United Colonies built a supermax prison they call the Lock. The UC is so clever. Supermax prison, Lock, Key. Cute, huh? We've got everything the fleet needs right here. Of course, you've got to pay for it. Remember, on the key, credits are king. What the hell is this?
All right, hang on, Nev. Before you get pissed, I've got my hands full.
Jasmine,
Sweetie, I'm trying to give a tour here. So you want to tell me why those damn doors are sealed?
It's called a malfunction. You know, that thing I spend most of my day dealing with. Believe me, my people are on it. Have a little faith for once.
Aww. And you always, Angel.
This here's Jasmine. You need anything for your ship, she's got you covered. We'll hit up the depot next since these doors have given out on us. So anyway, we were talking about the lock. About 100 years ago, the prisoners down there rioted and took over the place. After stealing some ships, they were actually able to make it up here and took over the key.
About time you brought us new blood, neighbor. I was getting tired of trading with the same old faces.
You're just ticked everyone's getting wise to your ridiculous prices, Alutra. Anyway, welcome to the depot, where you'll be lucky if these blood-sucking leeches don't bleed you completely dry.
Whoa. It's not our fault that people don't appreciate how much it costs to get untraceable merchandise onto the key.
Neva's just lining because she thinks she lost a little cash.
I hope you came with credits.
She should have done her homework.
Yeah, sure, laugh it up. I'll remember that next time I need something from you cheapskates. Let's move on. Back to my story. After the liberated prisoners grabbed the key, they established it as a base of operations and began pirating the spaceways. That was how the Crimson Fleet began. Of course, Jasper Crix had a lot to do with all that, but we'll get to him later. Rook, meet Zuri, queen of the rare exports.
If I don't have it, you don't need it.
Neuroamps, blueprints. Hit her up and she'll take care of you.
Speaking of which, you still owe me for that last purchase, Neva. It's like 5 figures. Don't make me collect it the hard way.
The hard way? Oh no. Rook, protect me from Zuri's vengeance. Enough of the bullshit, Zuri. I'll pay you when I pay you. Deal with it. Got a problem with that? Take it up with the boss. On the right? Got Bradley from the Trade Authority. I'm sure you know the deal there. He'll buy pretty much anything, no matter how hot. Then we got our med bay on the left, run by the one and only Samina Misra. She'll patch you up, if you've got the money. We don't run any free clinics up in here, you know? Okay, this is our final stop. Over there, you've got the last Nova. Bog serves watered-down drinks at ridiculously exorbitant prices. And right here is the most important place on the entire station. The Reckoner's Core, run by the incomparable Shinya Voss.
Another new rook, Neva? I can't believe Delgado still lets you recruit, given what happened with the last one.
You mean Austin Rake? It's been taken care of, all right? I don't like loose ends, and this rook is the one who tied it off.
Perhaps next time you'll try to be a bit more discerning regarding your choices. It's far more cost-effective.
Yeah, love you too, darling. Anyway, Shinya handles our lifeblood. The money. We call him our Reckoner, but if you ask me, he's actually a pain in the ass.
And Neva will slit your throat if she thinks you'll bleed creds.
Go to hell, Voss. Take care of our new friend here, or I'll find a way to pull the pin on that little party popper in your chest. Anyway, Shinya will get you set up in our system. I've got real work to do. Once you're done, head upstairs and I'll introduce you to the boss.
Time for a proper introduction. I am Shinya Voss, the official Reckoner for the Crimson Fleet. And since Neva so thoughtfully mentioned it, yes, this is a bomb embedded in my chest. And no, I'll never know the meaning of the word humble. In fact, I find Delgado's idea of a security measure to be quite empowering. No. See, it doesn't work that way. You new members have no patience, no appreciation for history. Since I oversee the bulk of transactions and maintain all accounts for the fleet, I'm a prime target for information. Should our enemies capture me or I grew any semblance of a moral conscience, you might consider me the greatest threat we have. For Delgado, the bomb grants peace of mind and a certain degree of safety. Essentially, but I sleep soundly knowing I'm one of the few that can piss Delgado off and live. Should I die, all of my knowledge, the accounts, the credits, it would be a mess. He wouldn't dare. He holds the trigger, but we all know that my death cripples the fleet. Call the bomb a weapon of last resort. It's why he's the boss. Of course, I'm not the first reckoner to bear a bomb under my ribcage, but Delgado was smart enough to continue the tradition. Now, let me get you set up. A moment while I convene with the Corps. Thanks to advanced modifications even Eugen would envy, I can interface directly with our mainframe and the Galbank network. This allows me to move and clean credits faster and more efficiently than any run-of-the-mill cyber runner. There, you're done. All you need now is Delgado's blessing, and you'll be one of us. None, other than my chest and arm modifications, I am but a simple man. Is the interview over now? Can we get back to work? The perfect segue into my final subject. Thanks to our relations with contacts across the galaxy, we always have a steady stream of jobs available. I've granted you all the necessary permissions to access these listings at any time using the computers that surround the core. If Nava's chosen wisely, we certainly will. Now, I believe that covers all I have to say, so you can run along to Delgado. Take the elevator to the upper level. You should be able to find your way from there, I hope.
All right, listen up. You can all stop complaining. Atrium to cargo bay doors have been repaired.
Ah, there is our other new recruit. So, now that we are all here, it's time to get down to business. The two of you are the only rooks that have made the latest cut. The rest, well, let's just say they won't be joining us ever again. Neva's willing to put her neck on the line and vouch for you, which means you've got what it takes to join the Crimson Fleet. You'd better not disappoint, or you'll find yourself answering to me, personally. All right, let's get started here. When you sign up with the Crimson Fleet, you're in it for the long haul. No one quits. No one retires. The only way out is death. You stay loyal, or you pay the consequences. Fleet before friends. Fleet before family. Fleet before yourself. Boss. Good. You're getting it already. I like that.
Can we get on with this? I want to get drunk at the last Nova.
I am impressed. That is the first intelligent thing you have said this entire time, Mathis. Since you two seem so eager to move forward, let's get to your next job. Pack your cold weather gear, Rooks. Where we are going, you're going to need it.
Oh, God, don't tell me you're dragging him down to Suvorol for another one of your little initiation runs. 10 Johns to the surface, 12 dead Rooks. You'd think by now you would have given up on that goddamn campfire story.
Crix's legacy is no story, neighbor. We've got fresh eyes in the fleet, and if these two want to impress, They're going to help me search those ruins.
I hope you're right, Dale. That new code we grabbed for the lock cost us a ton of credits. And a decent...
Initiation, as Neva calls it, is your chance to see where it all began. On Suvorov with Jasper Crix. Crix led the riots that gave birth to the Crimson Fleet. And if his legacy is still out there, we're going to be the ones to find it. Through a bit of luck and a hell of a lot of cash, Neva was able to get her hands on an access code to the inside of the lock. This will be the first time someone from the Crimson Fleet has set foot in there for, well, since Crix left the place behind. It has been frustrating being this close to potential clues, but not being able to find a way through those prison walls. Of course. Where else could I find such a perfect location to weed out any rooks who'd be wasting the fleet's time? What? Were you expecting a goddamn graduation ceremony? Think I'm just going to slap a skull on you and send you on your way? Make no mistake, you are being tested all the time. Every job you take will be under constant scrutiny. And Neva? Well, she's just waiting for you to screw things up. Before Crix left the fleet, he left a message talking about a major score. One that would set up the fleet to be a big player in the settled systems. Somewhere down the line, they started calling it Crix's legacy. And everyone who's tried to find it has wound up empty-handed, missing, or dead. If we're gonna beat those odds, we'll first need a lead. And I would wager we will find one on Suvorov.
Dale's leaving out the best part. That this whole search is based on a handful of words on a very old slate. Crix left a lot of big talk on that recording, and not a lot of facts. Some of us believe in it more than others.
Don't listen to her. When we get our hands on Crix's legacy, the fleet will be operating at a completely different level. We will become more than a match for UC Sysdef. Listen to the words that I am saying. The legacy is real. You will find that out in due time, provided you're willing to put in the work. Nothing worth having ever comes easy. Exactly. Now you're beginning to understand. Okay, enough discussion. We have got a lot of work to do. To that end, the next stop is the lock. I've had Jazz feed the coordinates into your ship's computer. Since Mathis doesn't have a ship, he's going to ride with me. I'll see you down there, Rook. Don't keep me waiting.